Hey, hello everyone.
I'm Andre,
the creator of RuneScape Maker.
In this video, I'm going to show you the basics of REM.
As you know, livescape games are a huge success around the globe, but before that, point-and-click games were already a thing. I actually created quite a few over the years, and that's how I noticed they were coded in a procedural way, always with conditions and instructions, mostly to hide and show things. For example, if you click on a closet, it will show you the interior of this closet, and then you find a key, then you click on it, it will disappear and then appear in your inventory. If you use this key on a closed container, it will show an open version of this container, and the key will be removed from your inventory, and so on.
It was pretty clear to me that a tool could be created to build escape games without requiring a high level of technical knowledge.
Let's get into it and you'll see exactly what I mean. Once you created an account and validated your email, you'll be able to create your first game. Just choose the name that will appear in the URL address and you can start editing. I'll call this one Tutorial. So here's an example of a new game project. By default, it will display a door and its knob. If you click on the preview button above the game area, you can already see a glimpse of a game in another tab. Clicking on the door will display a message saying it is locked. There is nothing else you can do for now. Close the browser tab and get back to the editor. If you click on this door again, you can see a panel with its settings. It says, on click, show small message. And the message is, the door is locked. This is one of the possible instructions. It's as simple as that. You can also show a secret code. You can request a secret code. Let's suppose you have a save and you want the player to give a code for it to be open. You can add things to the player's inventory and you can end the game. Once the player solves all the puzzles you imagined, this is probably the instruction you're going for. I would say these are the key instructions you have to know, and everything else is based on showing and hiding graphics.
For your first steps with RuneScape Maker, I would say you can just ignore the buttons you see above. Now let's be creative.
How could the player open this door? You have to see each wall view as a canvas. You put graphics as a layer, one over each other, and select what is shown and when it's shown. Let's add a key, for example. Go to the tab titled Available Items, and every graphic that can be added to your game will be there. Under Basics, you can choose a key. It will automatically be added to the game area. You can move it around, but for now you can leave it wherever you want. Now, go to its settings. You can say that on click, it will add to the inventory this, it means itself, and then hide also this. There's no need to keep the key visible once it's in the player's inventory. Now let's check if the instructions work well. Save. Preview the game. Click on the key. It disappears and it's indeed added to your inventory. Now you can click on it from your inventory, but unfortunately, you can't do anything with it. If you click on the door, nothing happens. You have to create the interaction between the key and the door. Close the preview and get back to the editor. This time you will click on the door and under item settings, you're not going to choose on click, you're going to choose on click while selecting. And then it will be key one, the only key available. And what will happen? In this case, it should open the door. So basically, end game. Let's test it one more time. So, you're in a room, there's a door, there is locked, you find a key, and you use the key to get out. It's a bit simple, but it works. And that's basically it with RuneScape Maker. Of course, you can make it more complex, create puzzles, and make it difficult to find the key, put the key in a safe, and then have the player find a code to this safe, this code being hidden in a book, for example. And there are many other options. I just wanted to guide through the first steps. Please let me know if this was helpful, if I should do more tutorials, more advanced. I apologize for my English, my accent. I'm French. But if this was helpful to you, please let me know. Ask me any question you want in the comments. And that's it. Hopefully I'll see you in another video. And yeah, please let me know if I should do another one. Bye.